Assalamu alaikum, ahlan bikum. Good day to everybody. My name is Dr. Pieter D Hooghe. I'm one of the orthopedic surgeons here in the orthopedic department. I'm Belgian nationality and I have special focus interest on the treatment of lesions of knee and ankle, foot and ankle. Together with my team members, we do a lot of research on the return to play. We recently published a book that covers from head to toe all the return to play protocols, and I'm happy to join with you today to discuss a few relevant topics in that regard, especially with the World Cup that is giving us so much passionate moments all over the world, and it's a pleasure to join. Now, when we talk about especially foot and ankle injuries, we need to check the epidemiology of it. What does it mean? It means what's out there, what do the teams encounter, because it's not just the player, it's the coach who has to understand the problem that is there. It's the technical staff who needs to know how to bring back a player, what we call back to conditioning of the performance. We need to understand that the medical staff has a big influence on the coaching of the medical problem towards the coach, and so on. So epidemiology means that we need to know what is the problem in the global perspective. And I brought here for you an ankle, and we can discuss maybe a little bit from a visual point of view the problem. If you remember, prior to the World Cup, so many players were at risk of getting into shape towards the world stage of football that is now taking place in Russia. Let's consider Neymar. He had a fracture on the midfoot. As you can see here, this is the bone that was giving the whole of 2 million Brazilian people getting in doubt on whether he could play or not. Luckily, thanks to the team efforts of the club doctors, the team doctors of the national team, the performance people, the physiotherapists, the coaches, and the whole entourage, they were able to get him back. Now, that's just one bone, but there's so many. Let's talk about Eden Hazard from Belgium. He had a fracture over the distal ankle. If you look at Cavani now in Uruguay, will he play against France or not? The whole country is in doubt. Why? Because he has a calf problem that is going towards the ankle. And if you look at the possibilities, even a simple calf injury grade one, as we call it, can give a lot of days of problem in order to get that player back. You have limited time to get them back, and it all depends on the grading of the lesion, the player's perception of the pain and the possibility of playing, and also the location. In the muscle, the calf heals faster than on the junction of the muscle with the tendon. If it's in the tendon, it heals even on a later stage. So our research here at the house has shown that, for example, for an elite player to kick a ball in a repetitive way, you have about 800 newton of force that is going to that specific area of the ankle. As you can see, the continuous repetitive movement of kicking the ball creates microtrauma over the front side, mainly on the inside of the ankle. Now, that is something to discuss, of course, on a regular basis, but if you have that repetitive kicking over and over again in these elite status global soccer fields, then there becomes a problem towards trauma, and that's where the medical staff comes in to know how bad it is or not. If you look at, for example, Nasser Chadli in the Belgian game, he ran 32 kilometers per hour in the sprint to finish the final goal against the Japanese. Now, it's just not about balance or only overload. It's about what we call the whole package of the ankle movement. It has to move, it has to be strong, it has to be stable, but it has to be able to do excellence in performance also. And a sprint is very different from a football kick, but an ankle has to hold it. If you look at the Cavani case, what you can see is that it's not just only a performance sport, it's also a contact sport. So whether you have overload in your tendon, or you get a kick, or another type of injury came on the ankle, there's so many variables that the ankle has to take. And the complexity of that is the big challenge for the medical staff, but also the reward once they get him or the female player in the good perspective, just towards the game. Because when you look at the coaching staff, they have faith in their medical staff. They know that it's going to be evidence-based, well-documented, well-directed. But their question is just, will he play or not? And we're all eager to see if the medical teams can bring that to life. Looking forward.